Hi, I'm Jared with Fun Science Demos. In a previous video, we talked about making aluminum foil boats and seeing how much weight those aluminum foil boats will hold until they eventually sink. Well, today we're going to talk about making different shapes with our aluminum foil boats. The boat building process is exactly the same. You'll need a ruler, heavy-duty aluminum foil, and a marker or pencil, along with the scissors, and then you're ready to go. So we've zoomed in so you can get a closer look at how this works, but the process is the same. We're going to start with a shape. In this case, I'm going to draw a triangle. I want to center that triangle in the center of my aluminum foil. So I can measure that. So let's go with a 10 centimeter base for my triangle. And let's say that we want our triangle to have a height of 10 centimeters. So now I'm going to just mark the apex of my triangle. Line up the corner dots and connect them. One more side, and my triangle is complete. So now that's going to be the shape of the bottom of my boat. Now, I just simply need to expand my triangle out by lining up the ruler with the edge and then tracing the opposite side of the ruler. I'm going to go and make my way around the entire triangle. It's really important for these different shapes to extend your lines as long as you possibly can. Last side, line up the ruler. Trace the outside. And now I have an inner triangle and an outer triangle, and I'm ready to cut out the outer triangle. So we have our boat cut out. Now it's time to make the sides. And to make the sides, I'm going to fold the outer edge until it lines up with the inner line. Just like this. Line up the outer edge with the inner line and make a nice clean crease. Work your way around the shape. Line up the outer edge with the inner line. Make a crease. Now you don't need to worry about this little tab. We'll take care of that in a second. One more outer edge. Line it up. Crease it. Now if these tabs bother you, you could fold them in to get rid of them. Or you could trim them off to get rid of them. It doesn't matter whether you trim it or fold it. I personally like to trim it so I don't have much foil in my corners and it doesn't get in the way when I go to pinch the sides. Now it's time to fold up the sides of our boat. To do that, I want to fold along that inner line. I'm actually going to make a crease because it works a lot better when I put a crease in and unfold it. Unfold it, next side, put a crease, unfold, then fold one last time along the line. Now, I'm ready to bring my sides up. It gets a little tricky because I want to put a crease in that corner as I fold my sides up. Same thing, put a little crease in the corner so my sides are able to fold up at the same time. Now you can start to see it taking shape. Little pinch in the corner, and I'm almost there. Now I have to just fold these tabs. I'm gonna fold it this way. Fold this corner this way. Pinch the corners, pull the sides if they're a little loose, then they'll tighten right up. And this one, I'm gonna fold over. And now, I have a beautifully formed triangular boat. Now, the awesome thing about that design technique is that you can use the same technique to make different shaped boats. Trapezoid boat, a parallelogram boat, but instead of showing you how to do it, we're gonna challenge you to see if you can make these on your own using our same technique. The neat part about making boats that are different shapes is that you can compare them to see which boats work better. And that's exactly what scientists do. Now, the real challenge is to see if we can use this technique to make a boat that has a round base. Here we go. Now, to make a circular boat, I could use a ruler if I was willing to drill some holes in that ruler that would allow me to make a circle, but I'm going to use a compass. So I want my circle to be in the center of my aluminum foil, exactly like all the other designs. For my circle, I am going to mark the center of my circle with my compass, and I'm going to measure out and have a smaller circle for a base. Now, I don't want to move my compass because I'm going to extend out further and make a bigger circle around my center one. You'll notice this is very similar to the other designs, but in this case, we have a circle. So we've zoomed in so you can get a better look at how we're going to fold our circular boat. Now this one is a little tricky. You can pick any point on your circle to start. I'm going to say follow the same process. Fold the outer edge of my circle until it hits the center line. You're going to notice it's not going to be exactly smooth. So after that fold, I'm going to come over to this end right here. I'm just going to start repeatedly folding the outer edge of my circle up to the inner edge. I'm just going to go right to where that peak is formed. I'm going to keep folding off of the end of that fold. And you'll notice I'm creating the edge of my boat. I just have to make a lot more folds than I did in the other boat designs. Fold the outer edge. This one, I think I'm going to fold like that. And then one more fold to bring it up. Okay, now I'm ready to fold up the sides of my boat. Now this is the trickiest part because I can't crease that inner circle to make the folding easier. I'm going to start to fold up, and as I fold up, you'll notice, watch what happens to the edge or the side of my boat as I start to fold around. I have a lot of extra material. So what I'm going to do is overlap and fold that material together to form a pleat. And as I start folding up the edge, anytime I have a little extra, I'm going to fold it in on itself. And I'm going to keep going, a little bit of extra there. Just pinch it together. I fold this up. There's a little bit of extra. Now you can see my side starting to take shape. Anytime you have a little bit of extra aluminum foil, just pinch it together and form a little bit of a pleat. Or a fold on the side. Now you might notice you'll have a little low spot on your boat. That's why you may decide to choose to make the edge or the outer circle a little bit bigger so you know you have a standard size for the side of your boat. After you fold the aluminum foil in on itself, you should have a circular boat. So we have a tray full of boats that are all different shapes and sizes floating in our little container. But scientists and engineers are always trying to figure out how to make something better. So how do we figure out which shape boat works the best? Well, that's going to be our next video. We're going to talk about how we measure the bottoms of the boat to compare how many paper clips each boat can hold. If you want some other ideas for STEM challenges, check out our YouTube channel, Fun Science Demos. Science is so cool, especially when you can design something and make it on your own. Whatever floats your boat. Thanks for watching.